am Roland, and we're at MWC 2019, and we're looking at a very special device. This is the SMG889. SMG888 was supposedly a kind of Galaxy S9 Mini, and some people thought that the SMG889 was going to be a small S10. But what it actually is it's a super specialized rugged devices for public service use. So your local fire department, police, or the train company, they can buy this device and put it into use as a combination of services and devices that is for public safety, basically, or for public services. So police can combine this with their laptops, other solutions like cameras and multimedia devices to communicate in public service. What it actually is kind of a super rugged Galaxy S9, because there's tech in there that's usually or has been in the Galaxy S9. What you get is a 5.2, I think it's a 5.2 inch screen that runs as a 2560 by 4040 resolution. It is a very nice panel. It is also very bright, so you can use this in very bad conditions like super bright areas, and it also is dimmable to a very low level. As you can see, this is housed in a very rugged case. It has the same casing as the SMG888 used to have. So it's super rugged, very thick, and very heavy. You can basically hit people with this and they will probably suffer a lot. You get the same hardware buttons down here like on the Galaxy Active that was available in Europe. And the S8 and all these devices also had these buttons down here. There was this rugged device from Samsung that was, I can't remember the name right now, but it was kind of popular between hikers and other people that like rugged devices, construction workers, for example. This runs Android 8.1, and they're using a special solution to make it able to call other devices through the network in a kind of group call. So you hit this button and then you talk to a bunch of people that are in the same group call, safe, secure, connected, for police to talk to each other, for example. Spec-wise, we have an 8-megapixel camera up here. There are the hardware buttons down here, and under the hood is the Exynos 9610, which is the same octa-core SoC that was used in the Galaxy S9, because this runs it's an octa-core SoC that runs at 2.7 GHz, and it's combined with 4 gigs of RAM and 64 gigabytes of flash storage. And apart from the octa-core SoC and the memory you get also a pretty decent camera setup, because this back here is the same camera that was in use on the Galaxy S9. It has a 12.2 megapixel sensor with a variable aperture going from 1.5 to 2.4, and it's combined with this big massive 3-LED flash that also functions as a flashlight. And right next to the camera is also your fingerprint reader in a pretty, we all know that this is an odd position, right? Under the hood here, under this cover, is a 4,500 milliamp hour battery that will probably get you through the day. And that's also an important feature of this device, because this has to work all day in shift work at police stations and everywhere else. You can also take off the cover to access the SIM slots and everything, and the memory slot, so you can definitely extend the storage on here. Let's take a quick look around the device. I think it's about 15 millimeters in thickness. Up here is the power button. Up there is a holder for your lanyard, and up top is where the power button is located, plus your headset jack. And if you go over to the left, this is again where it gets interesting. They have integrated this big push-to-talk button that lets you talk to other devices in your local, in the network that is used by the secure security forces, or by the fire department, or your train company, because there's like a Finnish train company that is using this device and in their service. Up here is the volume rocker, and down here behind this flap is a USB Type-C port that lets you charge the device quickly. What's also interesting is that this thing is super rugged. Again, it's waterproof, dustproof, and will probably survive drops from a bit greater heights than the usual rugged phones. Down here are a bunch of pogo pins and the speech mics. So these pogo pins make it able to put this thing in a docking station or into a bunch of accessories. So you can get kind of a shell for this, where you can get an additional antenna plus a bit more battery that lets this device last longer. So this is, again, a thing that you won't be able to buy just locally at your local retailer. I know there's a bunch of people that wish you would be able to buy this because this is kind of the Galaxy S9 Active that never came out. Let's just hope that Samsung returns to that concept of doing rugged devices at some point in the future. So this has been a quick look at the unnamed SMG889. It's kind of a public service use device from Samsung here at NWC. And I'm Roland. If you like what I do on my channel, follow me on Twitter or subscribe to the YouTube channel, and I will see you later.